Well, she's a MasterChef judge, food critic and Gold Logie nominee. And now Melissa Leong is going back to her roots as a writer, this time for kids with her very own children's book, A Taste Adventure with Melissa Leong. And it comes out this month and takes little readers on a delicious adventure around the world. Would you please welcome Melissa to the show? To see you.
So good to be on the desk finally. It's always, you know, throughout COVID I've been the tiny little green room just across the way, so it's really nice to be in your company.
Been allowed out.
Yeah. I'm allowed out. Yes. Well, look out.
Now, Melissa, a lot of people would have thought if you're releasing a book, it'd be a cookbook or maybe even an autobiography. What made you decide you wanted to do a children's book?
Well, it's exactly that. It was my tiny act of defiance because, you know, when you take a job like mine, people sort of say, well, you'll be putting out some kind of book, and I may at some point, but I just sort of thought, well, I'll just do this to just have a bit of a lull for myself. Like, why not a kid's book?
But they're very, like, you've gone into rhyming words, which is very tricky. And at one part in your book...
Oh, no.
It's so the word Eiffel.
Yes.
And you rhymed it with caramel.
Yeah.
Now, Melissa, I'm just going to ask you, did trifle ever sort of seem like it was a possibility? Did that come into your head or was...
Look, I'm still new at this, so just, you know, going gently. But, I love the idea of encouraging kids to fall in love with food because that's when I fell in love with food. I have a family who really loves to sort of express their love and joy for each other through food. And so by being able to kind of maybe incite a bit of excitement around trying new foods and things like that, I just sort of thought that might be a fun way to go about approaching a project like that.
I was just going to say, and caramel truly is a word that excites me.
Right.
Anything with caramel.
Just cover it in caramel and it's all good.
Caramel trifle? That's good gear.
Do you think kids, though, now have a much broader... palette? Like, I remember, I would have been terrified of sushi growing up, but now I see nieces and nephews devouring the stuff.
It's on canteen lunch orders and everything, you know. Yeah. In some schools I've seen, you know, the fridge orders going on for school lunches, and you can order sushi at the tuck shop, and that's pretty great. So do I think that kids are being a bit more sophisticated about food? I definitely think so. I think thanks to shows like MasterChef over a decade, you know, the IQ of our country in terms of sharing each other's cultures through food has only grown. And, definitely. There are a lot of kids who can cook better than I can.
I've heard young kids refer to their parents preparing dinner as plating up.
Yeah.
Does that speak to the massive impact of MasterChef?
I'm so sorry. So sorry. Quite possibly. I think it's definitely a testament to how much the show has had an impact on families watching together. Adding just that little bit of extra pressure on the parents can't hurt.
The clock is ticking.
Hamish, you got such a...
It's
got such a good point.
If you're watching out there, okay?
Melissa, I got a 5- and a 3-year-old at home, and I think my 5-year-old asked one day, she said, what is that? And I said, couscous. And she's like, pearl or normal? Like,
what are we...
I do live in the inner north of Melbourne, though, as well, so they know their acai bowls,
they
you know
really,
what I mean?
They really do.
You know, I love this. This is something you spoke about. You said...
Was it pearl or regular?
It was actually pearl. I prefer pearl, if I've got to be honest. Yeah. It was a beautiful sauce.
Slightly more surface area to take up the flavours.
Yeah, you're exactly right. You should look after my kids. That was not an answer I had. I'm like, that's just the only option,
yeah,
mate.
Yeah, that's what you're having.
Well, you can get your hands on A Taste Adventure with Melissa Leong from September 15th. It's a beautiful book, even if caramel doesn't rhyme with Eiffel.
It does in a French accent, though. Caramel, Eiffel.
Beautiful.
You win, Melissa.
Would you please thank Melissa Leong?